A very good morning to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Allow me to introduce myself to you. My name is Justin Jacob, and I'll be your MC for the next two exciting days. We'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of you gathered here this fine morning, and welcome to the 14th successive edition of the IESA Summit Vision Summit 2019, the largest event of ESDM in Asia. The IESA Vision Summit 2019 is a great platform for businesses to envisage the future and drive the initiatives and policies of the industry that will propel the government to succeed in the thought process of think global but do local and our own Make in India. This summit will focus on different strategies to aim at the turnover of $400 billion in the domestic electronics consumption by 2025, along with promoting ease of doing business for the entire electronic system, design and manufacturing of the ESDM sector, and encouraging industry-led research, development, and of course, innovation. The IESA Vision Summit is an eminent platform for to meet global industry leaders, engage with delegations from different countries, interact with policymakers, connect with ESDM startups, and get access to some interesting product launches, and of course, it goes without saying, to enhance your business products. Ladies and gentlemen, we encourage you to make the most of the next 2 days. And once again, welcome to the IESA Vision Summit 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, before we move into the agenda for the day, in the wake of the recent terrorist attacks that have taken the lives of our brave Jawans, I'd like to request that all of you stand in solidarity to pay homage to our brave Jawans and the sacrifice. I request that you all please remain standing in silence as we remember them, their great sacrifice, and their families for a minute. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Kindly be seated. As an initiative towards a noble cause, IESA would like to request the IESA community present here this morning to pledge your contribution towards the welfare of the families of those who have lost their lives recently protecting our country. The mobile app of Vision Summit has an option for you to pledge. You can also write in the pledge register kept at the registration counter by sending an email to vs@iesaonline.org. Ladies and gentlemen, our goal is to contribute 25 lakh rupees. And now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, to kick off things, please turn your attention to the AV screen for our curtain raiser video. We'll be right back. behalf of IESA, I'd like to invite onto the stage Mr. Anil Kumar Muniswamy, Chairman IESA, and Mr. Rajesh Ram Mishra, President IESA. I'd like to request them please come up on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the dignitaries that will be joining them on stage this morning. I'd like to request all of you to please give them a big round of applause as we welcome them to this event. And I'd also like to request Mr. Anil Kumar Muniswamy to present a small token bouquet to our chief guest for this morning, Sri Gopalakrishnan, IAS Joint Secretary, MeitY Government of India. Ladies and gentlemen, please give them a big round of applause as he comes forward. Like to request our Chairman IESA to present a bouquet as we welcome Dr. Omkar Rai, Director General, SDPI. Ladies and gentlemen, please give him a big round of applause as we welcome him this morning. I'd like to request Mr. Rajesh Ram Mishra, President IESA, to welcome Nivruthi Rai, Country Head, Intel India, and Vice President, Data Center Group, Intel Corporation. Ladies and gentlemen, please give her a big round of applause as we welcome her this morning to this inaugural session. I'd like to request our President, IESA, to present a bouquet as we welcome P. Raja Manikam, CEO, Tesolv Semiconductor, to this inaugural session. Thank you very much. I'd like to request you to please be seated. I'd like to now request Mr. Anil Kumar Muniswamy, Chairman IESA, to deliver the welcome address.
Good morning and namaskara. Dear friends, I have two agendas today for my opening speech. First, I would like to introduce the honorable dignitaries who are sitting on the dais. And then I'll give a very brief introduction or work what we are doing at IESA, because there are a lot of first-time visitors for this Vision Summit. And many people have been asking, they are very curious to know what we are doing. So if I don't do that, I'm not actually doing justice to our secretariat, EC, our partners. So I would like to complete this as quickly as possible. First of all, I would like to welcome Sri Gopalakrishnan, IAS Joint Secretary, MeitY Government of India. Thank you, sir, for gracing this occasion. I would like to introduce Dr. Omkar Rai, Director General, SDPI. He is also our guide, mentor, and our partner. I would like to welcome Ms. Nivruthi Rai, Country Head, Intel India, and VP Data Center Group at Intel Corporation. She's also our industry partner, guide, and mentor. Thank you, madam. I would like to welcome Dr. Raja Manikam, CEO, Tesolv Semiconductors. And again, he is our partner, guide. Thank you very much, sir, for sparing this valuable time. And Rajesh Ram Mishra, our president. Let me tell you one thing. Our Deputy Chief Minister of Karnataka, Dr. Parmeshwara, was supposed to grace this occasion today. Yesterday I met him and he confirmed, and unfortunately I had to rush to Andhra Pradesh this morning because of some emergency. Could be political emergency, I don't know that. But he has conveyed his best wishes for our event, and he is trying his best to attend our award ceremony in the evening. Okay, let us hope that he will make it. So let me first, as I mentioned, my first part of the speech is over. So the second part, it's actually, I'm very proud that IESA, during the last 15 years, we have done a tremendous job. The credit goes to the past chairmen, past presidents, all the secretariat, ECs. At the same time, I would like to tell what we have done in the last 15 years. Because there are a lot of associations which are 100 years old, but in a very short span of time, IESA is able to make its presence felt, and today all the stakeholders are giving due respect to our association. It's only because of our work. Let me just give you a brief introduction. I'm very happy to announce that IESA is transforming into an intelligent electronic solutions and actions organization. IESA is always in the forefront of coining some new terms. We came out with ESDM, Electronic System Design and Manufacturing. Today, all across the globe, they are using this term, which was actually coined by IESA. Again, we are coming out with Intelligent Electronic Solutions and Actions Organizations. This is the first time we are announcing at this Vision Summit. And with our new EC coming in last year, and new team members joining us at the Secretariat, I congratulate our President, Rajesh Ram Mishra, in taking up the reins of the organization with ease and becoming the guiding force for the future course of action. Thank you, Rajesh. IESA has been instrumental and supported the efforts of MeitY, our biggest stakeholders in electronics, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, in creating National Policy on Electronics, NPE 2.0, Electronic Manufacturing Clusters, EMCs 2.0, and is active member of the working groups defining new phase manufacturing program, PMP, microelectronics R&D programs, skill development programs, and others. IESA has been part of the 5G high-level forum constituted by Department of Telecom with their support in seeking create a 5G village in Bangalore as a sandbox environment for telecom technologies for rural urban India. Let me tell you, I was present at the launch of 5G, high-level committee report. The total economic opportunity 5G is going to create for the country between 2020 and 2030 is $1 trillion. Out of this $1 trillion, $250 billion goes towards acquisition of technologies and equipment. But the good news is the remaining $750 billion goes towards use case applications and the complete ecosystem which is present in India. Unlike the past 4G and other technologies, majority of the money that goes towards creating the ecosystem and the local companies will be benefited, in addition to MNC companies being partners for that. IESA has started supporting indigenous electronics development for strategic defense needs of the country. As industry member of the Committee for Indigenization of Software-Defined Radio for Armed Forces, we have contributed in defining the roadmap for this product. We are also in conversation with Bharat Electronics to see how indigenous products, ICs, can be made available to them for various defense projects. We have proposed co-development of multiple ICs for defense needs to Department of Defense Production and are expecting a positive response very soon. In collaboration with STPI, our partner who is here today, we are creating a second ESDM incubator at Bhubaneswar, building on the success of Electropreneur Park at Delhi, where we have incubated 23 startups that have achieved a collective valuation of 100 crores over past 2.5 years' time. We are going to support more such incubators along with STPI in the future across the country. I'm happy to announce that we are going to formalize that collaboration today. We are going to sign that MOU. I'm also happy to announce that today we are signing a formal collaboration with MeitY to support their entire startup effort as industry partner. We thank MeitY, sir, thanks for your support, for giving us this opportunity, and I invite all of you to participate in making this collaboration a great success. SFL, the Semiconductor Fabless Accelerator Lab, created in collaboration with Government of Karnataka, is poised to be a great success story and a game changer for Indian ESDM industry. We are seeing great traction from multiple states to set up similar hubs from Government of India in investing in such hubs as need of the hour, which is the need of the hour. And let me tell you, last year we inaugurated two Center of Excellences in Hubli, one at KLE Tech University for VLSI Center of Excellence, another one at Deshpande Foundation. It is for ESDM, that is for the electronic manufacturing. In addition to 8 crores of funding, what we actually invested towards creating these two startups, they have further invested another 8 crores, and it's going to be a 16 crores investment ecosystem, which we have gifted to the complete startup ecosystem. We at IESA have to walk on parallel tracks to make our design-led manufacturing vision a reality. Let me tell you that we came out with the new EC coming in last year. We came out with a vision that we are going to make India as the hub for design and manufacturing for the whole world by 2025. That's our new vision. So all our activities, all our actions are directed towards that. So to promote manufacturing and FDI in this space, we have been in collaboration with multiple ministries of government of India and multiple state governments. IESA was co-chaired at India-Japan joint working group discussion that happened in Tokyo in September last year and put forth 13 JV proposals in areas such as ATMP, PCB, LCD panel manufacturing, battery manufacturing in the front of Japanese industry. Let me tell you that we have been the leaders for driving this India-Japan joint working committee meeting. We have attended all the meetings, not only in India, also in Japan. Our Taiwan effort was a seed for investments announced by Taiwanese industry in Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. We have entered into an MOU with Korean trade agency KOTRA to facilitate investments from Korean companies into India. We have with us a director from KOTRA, Mr. Kim is sitting here with us. Thank you, Mr. Kim, for your support. We have had successful discussions with Russian Electronics Devices and Manufacturers Association and will be doing a joint roadshow very soon. Our Sweden office, which we started 2 years back, has been giving us positive feedback of interest from companies in the European region. We hope to see more action soon from there. We are partnering with Invest India to undertake an ESDM report with a focus on consumption of product solutions by consumers, government, and industry policy landscape and promotion of product design ecosystem. Let me tell you, we received an invitation to go with the Prime Minister of India to Korea on 21st. Because of Vision Summit, me and Rajesh could not join. This is important for us. But we are sending our Vice President to be part of this delegation in Korea. And soon after Prime Minister's speech in the afternoon on 21st, Invest India is making a presentation followed by IESA's presentation that shows that how much importance government is giving to IESA. I'm sure that going forward with all your support, we will accelerate the growth of intelligent electronics, not only in India, but also globally. Last but not the least, let me tell you what efforts we are doing in skill building. IESA has partnered with Electronic Sector Skill Council of India. Mr. Mohapatra is here. We have successfully trained thousands of workers who can go and work in EMS industries, electronic design companies, and manufacturing industries. ESSEA itself has achieved a turnover of 40 crores as of last year. I congratulate Mr. Mohapatra for his contribution, and IESA has been one of the stakeholders in ESSEA. I think we hold 20% stake. We have been working very closely, and I must mention that Mr. Gururaj, I'm not sure if he's here, he is the CEO of Wistron, who is the subcontractor to Apple. He told me that he is extremely happy with the quality of candidates he is getting from ESSEI. He thanked IESA and ESSEI for our efforts. Thank you, sir. And NETRA, as you all know that it was a brainchild of IESA. NETRA stands for National ESDM Technology Research Academy, which was actually started in Hubli at KLE Tech University. NETRA has been working towards training graduates from engineering colleges from fourth semester onwards and making them ready for the industry when they come out. Either they can join the industry, there is no waiting period to train them. At the same time, they can also become entrepreneurs on their own. So these are some of the small things that we have done. Thank you very much for your patience, and I hope I've explained what IESA is doing. And I would like to thank all our sponsors and industry leaders, those who have come from abroad, the local industry leaders and ecosystem partners such as startups, IoT companies, small and medium scale companies, all of you for making this event a grand success. Thank you very much.
That was the welcome address by the chairman IESA, Mr. Anil Kumar Muniswamy. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, as it's customary here in India, we will now have the ceremonial lighting of the lamp. I'd like to request our chief guest, Sri Gopalakrishnan, IAS Joint Secretary, Mighty Government of India, Dr. Omkar Rai, Director General, SDPI, Nivruti Rai, Country Head Intel India and Vice President Data Center Group Intel Corporation. P. Rajamanikam, CEO to Solve Semiconductor. Mr. Anil and Mr. Rajesh to please do the honors of lighting the lamp. Gentlemen, the ceremonial lighting of the lamp as we formally inaugurate the IESA Vision Summit 2019. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, gentlemen. We'd like to request you to please take your seats.